Welcome to a new Fresh Plastic video. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to build an Extrusion Pro machine. It's kind of the same principle as the smaller version, except this one is more robust, it has a higher output, and it's a bit more efficient. So if you're looking for a small machine that is simpler to build, I would recommend to build the old one. If you're looking for a more advanced machine for production that you can really rely on, build this one. Overall, the making of this machine is a bit more complex, requires a bit more skills and advanced tooling with milling and lathe. Now, you can fully build this machine yourself. You can buy parts on the bazaar or buy the whole machine there. But in this video, we're going to show you step by step how to build it yourself. If you want more information about this machine, like the amperage it uses, the wattage, the kilogram per hour output, you can find it on the website. And in the download kit, you can find all the technical drawings, blueprints, the bill of materials, etc. And in this video now, Peter Bas is going to show you how to build it.
Hi.
Hi.
Bye.
I'm Peter Bas. I'm going to build the Extruder Pro. And I'm going to show you in 9 steps how to build this step by step. So we'll start off with making the bearing body and shaft assembly. Next up is the barrel inlet, the hopper, the barrel, the electronics, and the frame. Finally, we're going to assemble everything and do a test run to make sure everything runs smoothly. First up, we're going to make the bearing body and shaft assembly, which is this part. The main function of this assembly is to support the extrusion forces which act on the screw during extrusion, which can lead up to several tons. So it has to be really strong and solid. This is probably the most complex part with a lot of lathe work and machining. It consists of 4 parts we need to make and some purchasing parts to put everything together, like bearings, seals, and a clamp. Okay, let's start. I'm going to show you a neat trick to get the hole pattern right on the parts using just a regular drawing without any fancy equipment. Cut out this piece of drawing, tape it on this part. Then using a center punch, we will make center punches on the part using the drawing pattern.
Now, I've completed the bearing housing, the lathe part, and the drilling of the holes. So now I'm going to make the radial hole for the grease nipple.
This part is all done. Now I'm going to make the cutout in the transition piece part. The cutout allows for ventilation through to the bearing part to make sure the heat from the barrel doesn't leak to the bearing part on the back here. And also allows for access to the coupling between the screw and the screw coupling part. You can use a wrench through those holes to tighten and loosen that part. So that's convenient.
At this point, we have finished the extruder bearing housing and the transition piece. These two parts will form the basic body of the extruder. So we are going to assemble them now by preparing them for welding and press fitting them together using the press on these locating rings.
An important thing to look out for while assembling these two parts are the positions of the holes. So the bearing body has the grease nipple here on top, and this hole is aligned during the center line on with the grease nipple. So this position should be on top here. And as you can see in the drawing, the slot in the transition piece should be also in the up-facing position while for assembly. And this hole is also aligned in the middle of this slot. So this hole and the hole in the back should be basically aligned with each other like this.
version 4 extruder is designed to use a bearing housing. The bearing housing houses two tapered roller bearings, and these two tapered roller bearings support the screw, or the screw coupling to be exact, in the axial and radial direction. This allows the axial forces from extrusion to be supported by these bearings and guided through the extruder itself, and allows the drive to be unloaded from axial forces on its own. And also the radial forces are supported by these two bearings. I'm going to use this shell. I'm going to press this inside the bearing housing using this tool, which is just a pressing tool, which will press the bearing inside the housing. So I'm going to use a hydraulic press for this because I have one. You can also use a hammer or some threaded rods to drive them into the bearing housing. Now we are going to fix up the bearing body assembly. For this we will need space bushing with the O-ring already assembled inside and greased up. We will need the shaft clamp to tighten everything together. And we will need a tool which consists of two parts, a tube and a block which will push the tube against these parts to take out the slack in the bearings. I will show you now how to assemble that. So, first things first, everything is greased up already. I will push this part over the shaft, and this part will push up to the bearing, and this face will seal onto this seal, so no grease can be pushed out and stay in to the part. Push it all the way down. Clean it up a little bit for the clamp, slide it over, and now I will use this tool to push this part down and to take out the slack in the bearings when I fix up the shaft, the coupling shaft into the bearings. So I'll slide this over. This part is just a part with a hole inside, and it will have a face for the bolt. And this bolt I will use to take out the slack. That's nice and tight. So now, to fix everything together, I'm just going to tighten up the shaft clamp. Now I can release this again. We have a fully assembled bearing housing. Don't forget to screw in a grease nipple and fill the bearing housing up with grease just to last everything longer.
This is the bearing body and shaft assembly. Which consists of the shaft, which rotates into bearing body. This is the point for greasing, and this part will hold the clamp bushing, which will retain the screw. Good job! You finished the most complex part of the whole machine. So next up, we're going for something a little bit more easy, which is the barrel inlet assembly, which is this part here, underneath the hopper.
At this point, I'm going to make the barrel flanges. The stock material is laser-cutted metal, 8mm thick. I deburred the edges on the outside, and we are going to use the lathe to cut the inner diameter to size and make a chamfer for welding it onto the tube. This is the drawing, the inner diameter. A good thing to know is it has to be a light press fit onto the tube. So it says a fit here, but it's good to check the outside diameter of the tube and make sure it's a few hundredths of a millimeter undersize compared to the tube.
I'm going to measure out the lengths for the inlet. At this point, we finished the three parts for the barrel inlet. And now we are going to assemble them according to this drawing, the same way. The good thing to know is how to align the holes compared to the inlet. They should be according to the drawing. If you don't do that on a proper way, then the chance is that the hopper won't be vertically, but under an angle, which would look ridiculous. So there's something to keep in mind, like the holes also in both of the flanges should be aligned as well, and the hole compared to the inlet should be in the upright facing position, so aligned here. Both these flanges will be pressed together. The long side will be on top. This side will go onto the long side like this, and the other flange will be on the other side, and it will be welded. These faces will be welded together, and then at the end we will flatten this side to make sure it's square compared to the barrel. Now I'm going to press fit the small flange onto the barrel inlet.
This is the barrel inlet assembly. This part will be mounted to the bearing body. This is the part where the granules will go inside the barrel, and this is where the barrel will be mounted. That's the barrel inlet done, so next up I'm going to make the barrel. The barrel is a heated tube where the screw rotates inside of, causing friction and thereby melting the plastic. Here I have the screw from the small extruder, and here I have the screw which we designed for the Extruder Pro. So as you can see, it's a lot longer and the diameter is a bit bigger, and we optimized the screw geometry in such a way that it is kind of multi-purpose and able to extrude a good output of the most common polymers we can find. So the screw will pump the molten plastic through the nozzle. We made this extruder with the internal 1-inch pipe thread, in where you can screw different kind of nozzle attachments to connect different kind of molds to make different kind of products. So let's make that.
At this point, I'm going to assemble and weld up the barrel. The barrel consists of three parts. The barrel tube, which is this part. It is machined down to length. It then has two chamfers on both sides, which are for welding. One side, the nozzle side, will get this barrel end piece. It has an internal pipe thread, 1-inch gas thread. And the other side has a locating ring, which will sit inside the barrel for positioning. And I will tag weld this here inside this cutter, and I will hold it into place with a threaded weld, then weld it all around. As you can see, the barrel end piece has this flat face in the end for the nozzle itself. It's also for sealing purposes, so it's pretty important to be flat and square. The other side will get this flange with the true holes, which will be assembled onto the barrel inlet later on. The inside of this flange is already machined to size to have a light press fit onto the barrel, and it has a chamfer. This is also a chamfer. I'm going to fill that up with welding and then square it up afterwards on the lathe again.
This is the barrel assembly, which consists of the flange, the tube, and the barrel end piece. Next, I'm going to make the motor adapter, which connects the whole extruder to the motor.
We designed it to be an inline part, so all the forces will go through the motor and the extruder itself, which makes this, the whole extruder a standalone unit. Therefore, we don't have to reinforce the frame anymore. The motor adapter consists of three parts. You will need to check the flange on the motor side for the hole pattern before you laser cut it. Therefore, you will need to check the centering ring diameter and the hole pattern of this motor to see if it fits your extruder. Right, let's make it. This is the motor adapter assembly with the extruder facing side and the motor facing side. So next we're going to make the hopper. It's kind of a basic thing, so you can freestyle it a bit here. We're going to make it a cone shape, so it has a good even distribution inside of the barrel inlet. And we're going to clamp it onto the barrel inlet using two clamps. This is the insulated hopper assembly with the insulation here, and this will sit on top of the barrel inlet like this. Right, that's the mechanical part done. Next up, we're going to do the electronics, which is this black box over here. So it has a frequency drive to control the motor speed from the screw, and it has three temperature controllers to control the temperature in three different zones of the barrel. This helps us to control the melting process during extrusion. You can make it yourself or use the laser cut files. I'm not going to go into too much detail about the wiring up. You can check the schematics in the download kit for more instructions about that.
This is an overview of the electronica box parts. Right now, I will measure up the holes to fit the heat sinks onto this plate. This will be the inside of the electronica box.
Okay, we will do the electronics now. For this, we will need the electronic box with space for the temperature controllers and the frequency drive display. We will need the electrical band heaters for around the barrel. We will need thermocouples. And I will use these clamping type thermocouples, which are really convenient for round barrels. Three temperature controllers to control the temperature of the barrel during operation. We will need a frequency drive to control the motor speed during extrusion. To switch everything on and off, we will need a main on-off switch. An emergency stop in case of an emergency. A plug, of course, to feed power to all of the electrics. And we will need cables from the plug to the electrical box and to the motor. And we will need some installation cable along with some connectors to connect all the wires together inside the box. So that's about everything. So I'm gonna do the electronics now. This is the finished box with all the electronics. Next up is the frame. It's pretty straightforward. If you made all the other parts before here, then this will be a breeze to go through. So we made all the parts, we made all the sub-assemblies, and now we're gonna make one proper machine from it. We start off by connecting the bearing body and shaft assembly to the motor adapter. Then we will install the screw with the clamp bushing. Then we'll slide over the barrel inlet assembly, and we will slide over the barrel, and the final extruder assembly will be slid in the motor, and we will tighten everything afterwards. Next up, I'm going to put it upright. I'll make sure that everything is clean and degreased. This is the clamp bushing. I will use this to clamp the screw into the coupling shaft. I'm going to do this before I assemble the bearing inlet into the bearing body, because now I have easy access to the bolts. It consists of two parts with a conical face in between. When I tighten these bolts, the conical face makes this side expand. Expanding it will make a tight fit between the shaft and the hub, thereby allowing it to transfer a lot of torque. All the way to the bottom. Right now, I want to tighten the bolts for the clamp bushing to the specified torque to make sure it's tight. To do that, and to prevent it from turning, I'm going to slide it into the motor using the key. Now I'll slide over the barrel inlet. The hole here should face the grease nipple here, and I will use 20 millimeter bolts for this one. Next up, I'm gonna slide over the barrel. I'm gonna use 16 millimeter bolts for that. Now this is all tightened up. The final thing is to install the extruder into the motor. Easy. Right, now I greased up the shaft with copper grease to prevent it from seizing into the motor. And I prepared a few bolts to tighten the motor adapter into the motor with some grease. The body of the motor is aluminium, and steel will corrode if we don't put grease between it. Now I will assemble it with the barrel inlet facing up, of course. Now we tightened up everything and finished installing the extruder on the motor. So now we are going to install the whole extruder on the frame.
I fixed the extruder onto the frame. Next up, I'm going to fix the subframe here for the electronic box, and I'm going to fix the electronic box itself into the frame.
Now we are going to mount the electronic box, and for that I'm going to need some help.
Now we are going to connect all the electronics to the extruder.
Okay, we installed all the heaters and the thermocouples. Now I'm going to connect the motor. Works. That's the motor connected. Now I'm going to install the hopper. So now the machine is all done. One thing I forgot to mention, to paint everything, small detail. So now I'm going to show you how to run and operate this machine. We have the motor and the heaters, and this display here will control the motor speed, and these three controllers here will control the three different zones of the extruder. This is the main switch to switch everything on and off, and this is an emergency stop for when everything blows up. You just press it like this. So let's try it out. First, we're going to switch on the machine, and then we set the temperatures to the required level. Before we turn on the motor, we have to make sure that the temperature are all up to the set level, just to make sure that all the plastic inside the barrel is molten. So it's up to the required level now. I'm going to start up the motor. Now throw in some plastic. It works. When it comes to maintenance from the machine, just every now and then make sure that all the heaters are still working, and the grease nipple on this position, just pump a little bit of grease inside of there every once every month.
So that was it for this video. Go to our website to find all the information, and you can also find there the download kit to download all the CAD files, blueprints, instructions. And make sure to visit our how-tos to show hacks, improvements, and tweaks made from this machine. And now, I would advise to watch the next video where you can see what you can actually make with this machine. Bricks, beams, small T profiles, or make massive I profiles. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, before you go, we just want to let you know that Precious Plastic runs on the supports and funds of people just like you. Everything we develop here is posted online for free, open source, so that people from all over the world can work on the plastic waste problem. If you're willing and able to help, please visit support.preciousplastic.com to make a donation or find another way you can help us.